Moses got up, I'm getting excited. He defended the seven daughters. Watch this. They drew the water from the well. And they went back home early that day. Now watch this, watch this, watch this, watch this renewal. The girls go in their house. And the daddy says to them in verse 18, why y'all home so early today?
Right.
Verse 19, the girls told him, there was this man by the name of Moses down by the well. And the shepherds, watch this, who were more concerned about sheep than people. Because they ran us out to get water for sheep and not people. They tried to run us away. But Moses helped us. Father said in verse 20, watch this. Well, why haven't you invited Moses to our house to eat?
Come on.
Y'all do know this is the same Moses.
Right.
Who has nowhere to go.
Right.
This is the same Moses who's on the run.
Yes.
Moses, come to my house.
Yes.
Moses, y'all, fast forward and accepts the invitation.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Moses left one house in shame,
yes,
but was welcome in another house.
Yes.
He left one house in shambles, but he received in another house and was made whole. He left one house as a fugitive,
yes,
and was received in another house as a hero.
Yes.
I wish I had a witness in here. That sounds like favor to me, y'all. Did I get a witness in here? And Burrell gave him favor also. Because Burrell said, listen, not only Moses do I want you to eat at my house, but he says in verse 20, I'm going to give you my daughter by the name of Zipporah to be your wife.
Yes.
Now God will give you not only favor, but God will take care of every need, yes, of your life. Is there anybody in here that knows God has been working in your life? Is there anybody in here that knows God has given you favor? I shake that nigga hand and say, the reason why I'm here today, it is because of the favor of God. I got to get ready to leave y'all now. The Bible says, God, excuse me, I'm losing my mind.
Come on!
That Reuel gave him a daughter, his daughter, Zipporah. And the Bible says Moses married her. And Zipporah gave Moses a son. And when God gives you favor, he will always give you a testimony.
Mm.
Have I got a witness in here?
My God!
To bother y'all this
Jesus,
morning.
Come on.
But is there anybody that has a testimony?
Yeah! Yeah!
Ooh,
yeah!
I feel like preaching in here. He not only will give you favor, but he will give you a testimony. I got some Bible for it, and I'm closing. The Bible says that Moses names his son Gershom, not for a memorial, not just for a namesake, but he names his son Gershom for a testimony. Because in verse 22, watch the words of this text. Moses says, I'm naming him Gershom because I have been a stranger in a strange land. I was a teacher. Let me go back over that again. He named him Gershom because he said, I have been.
Right. I once was.
Tell somebody that's past.
Yes.
Have I got a witness in here? It's in past tense. And I'm closing now. When God gives you favor, he won't let you stay the same way that you were. He said, I have been. Have I got a witness in here? And I hear Moses saying, I was a stranger, but I'm not a stranger anymore. I was in a strange land, but now it's familiar to me. And I need to tell some of y'all this morning that God wants to change your life. And when God changes your life, God will give you a testimony. But before you have a testimony, you gotta go through some trials and tests. Before you have a testimony, you gotta suffer some time. Before you have a testimony, you gotta be lied on. Before you have a testimony, you gotta feel like quitting sometime.
Yes!
When you realize that favor is working in your life,
yes,
you'll be able to say, yes, I cried, but I'm not crying anymore. Have I got a witness in here? Oh, yes, I suffered, but I'm not suffering anymore. Yes, I relied on, but I'm not worried about it anymore. I was ready to give up and throw in the towel, but I'm not going to quit. Is there anybody in here that knows God's hand is on your life? And because His hand is on your life, you survived some things that should have taken you out. You should have had a nervous breakdown, but I'm too glad that God favored you. Ooh, yeah, Lord, I'm glad I got favor today. Have I got a witness? I used to be broke, but I ain't broke no more. I used to be sad, but I ain't sad no more. I used to be a sinner on my way to hell, but I heard, I said I heard, the voice of Jesus, yeah, telling me to come on, I got to get out of here. Now, but touch somebody. God favored me. God favored me. I've been through hell, but I survived in the had Pharaoh trying to kill you. Had burdens you had to go through. Been stricken by sickness. Had friends walk off and leave you. Had family stab you in the back. Had coworkers trying to get you fired. But here you are, still praising God. Here you are, still giving him glory. And I tell you why, you're still here. Because of the favor of God. I heard an old preacher say, he walks with me. He talks with me. He tells me, I'm his own. Anybody here, glad you got favor. Anybody here, your testimony is, I never would have made it without the Lord. Yeah, I made it. Yeah, just we people, some of we made it because of God's favor. We didn't give up because of God's favor. We didn't go in the tower because of God's favor. Yeah, we are living testimonies. We should be there. So thank God, thank God, thank God.